2019 shapes up to be the best year for digital health yet. From a global FDA to AI in hospitals, let's take a look at what we wish to see this year. Here are the major trends that we look forward to.
This is Bertalan Meskó, and you're watching the channel of the Medical Futurist.
National digital health strategies. While technological development soars, healthcare systems around the globe struggle with unsustainability and a shortage of medical professionals. Digital health is the only viable way forward, and we would like to see more and more countries catching up. Denmark is already building a robust digital system for medical records and empowers e-patients with more focus on prevention. New Zealand's strategy focuses on patients as the point of care. And a small African country, Rwanda, is building their healthcare system so wisely that digital health startups are swarming the region and the newest technological marvels are rolled out nationwide almost instantly. Only 6 countries have some sort of digital health strategy, but we would like to see more and more governments to develop their own in the new year. Cross-border cooperation. It's going to be a slow process, but we hope to see the beginnings of borderless healthcare. Transnationalization can enable treatments outside the national healthcare systems. Just imagine a French patient sending a tissue of his tumor to a Belgian company specializing in precision diagnostics. They established that a Swiss pharma company has the exact type of clinical trial that the patient could use, so he gets healed by the joint efforts of numerous healthcare systems. It was unimaginable before, but with well-developed digital health tools, it can become a reality. Discussions about the global FDA. With cross-border cooperation comes the question of oversight. We already see the demand for a regulatory organization that goes beyond borders. Every day, there are more and more ethical and legal challenges like gene editing in China and genetic big data in the West. The emergence of some sort of a global FDA seems inevitable. Medical chatbots aiding medical professionals. 2019 could see the rise of health chatbots. Britain's National Health Service already used a chatbot for a trial period to reduce the burden on its non-emergency helpline. Unfortunately, the first experiences were mixed. Patients didn't trust the system, and they were able to play it to get an appointment with their doctor quicker. But as these bots develop and patients embrace digital health, the bots will be able to take off the burden on medical professionals when it comes to easily diagnosable health concerns or quickly solvable health management issues. Cars become the point of care. When it comes to the future of healthcare, this is not something you would say from the top of your mind, but cars could be one of our most valuable diagnostic devices. Mercedes already has cars that are able to tell if a driver has become too tired to drive. And they are aiming to arm their cars with more and more health sensors. The seat belt, the steering wheel, and practically anything the driver might touch can be used as a biometric sensor to gain information. They could help detect a drop in blood sugar or even an impending heart attack. We'd like to see more car manufacturers think about this progressively. An FDA-approved bioprinted tissue. The San Diego-based company, Organovo, is focusing on the technology of 3D printing biomaterials. They have successfully bioprinted liver tissues in 2014, and they seem to be years away from printing liver parts for transplantation. Based on their announcements, we already expected last year that their first bioprinted products could make it to the FDA in 2019, and we already saw a lot of regulatory discussions about 3D bioprinting. These will continue more intensively into the new year. A smart alarm revolution. There are tons of wearables, sleep sensors and sleep apps out there. Even fitness trackers can follow your sleep, but the holy grail of health tracking is the smart sleep alarm. Since we sleep in cycles, we can feel completely groggy or fully rested, depending on where we are in the cycle at the time of waking up. But smart alarms analyze your sleep and wake you up at just the right time. A few days ago, I realized that the Fitbit Ioniq has a smart sleep alarm feature. I tried it and it works wonders. I hope that the rest of the sleep tracker manufacturers will also pull it together And in a few years, when we look back, we won't even understand how we could torture ourselves by waking up to a regular alarm clock. AI-based algorithms and services approved by the FDA. As wearables and innovative digital health technologies swarm our lives and our hospitals, we have access to more health data than ever. And with AI, we have the ability to process them and gain insight that was unimaginable before. AI applications will help us with faster and more accurate medical diagnosis and cheaper, more effective R&D. IBM has already taken the first steps. Watson launched a special program for oncologists, which is able to provide clinicians with evidence-based treatment options. Deep learning and machine learning are ready to take healthcare by storm, and we hope we will see a flock of approvals in the near future as AI finally enters our lives. Big tech in big pharma. We've talked a lot about how Silicon Valley is looking into healthcare as their next big undertaking. Apple focuses on its consumer products to turn them into medical monitoring devices. Amazon is building on its logistics and distribution savvy to sell prescription drugs and medical supplies online. Google, as a pioneer in AI research, is betting on the analysis of big data. And even Uber wants to replace ambulances. Healthcare is a $3 trillion pie in the US alone, and it's ripe for disruption. These companies have clearly stated that they want a piece of that pie, and they have the ability to radically change healthcare for the better. Expect to hear more from them in the future. I hope you enjoyed this list about our expectations for 2019, and that you are just as excited about them as we are. If you'd like to hear more about these topics, you can find more about them in my new ebook on leanpub.com, and we all wish you a very happy new year.